twice. So this is called Eternal Triangle.
Thank you. few times tonight, there's a tune that I need to conduct. So there's a little extra space for, you know, traveling time.
Extra space for the bass player, too.
Don't get used to it. This is an arrangement recorded by Roy Eldridge with the Gene Krupa Band. And, I mean, it's a classic old swing era arrangement featuring one of the monsters of trumpet. And since Roy Eldridge was kind of superhuman, we've split up that solo, and it features the whole trumpet section, one after the next, one after the last, one after another. So the title is Rockin' Chair. Oh, my metronome. Got to make sure the tempo's right.
Thank you.
case Michael didn't give you the title, that's Blue All Over. And at the risk of blanking on somebody's name, because I have a history of doing this, it's not because I'm getting old. I used to do this 30 years ago introducing my big band. People I've known for decades, I will sometimes look at them and, but the soloists in order were Nick Martell on alto, I think, Ed Worth on tenor, Chris Rollins on barry, Jimmy Hansen on trumpet, Bruce Herring on trumpet, Ken Gleason on trumpet, Michael Beebe on piano, also the composer, and Alex Bauer on trombone.
I got all. I'll give it to myself.
Please do.
Next up is a tune from the Buddy Rich Library. The title is Dancing Men. And somebody in the band, I think maybe it was Ed, told me that the title comes from a Sherlock Holmes book. That there was a secret code that looked like a bunch of dancing men. Okay. I don't know that I hear that in the music.
One, two, three.
Jackson Men. That featured Peter on the tenor, me on trombone, my name's Don, and Rand in the Buddy Rich role. Well, when I noticed that this gig was landing on the 21st, my first thought was, oh, that's J.S. Bach's birthday. But he's 339, not a round number, so we didn't have to do that chart. Plus, that one's too hard to do on one rehearsal. And then I thought, oh, the 21st, that's usually the first day of spring. Well, this year, yesterday was the first full day of spring because of leap year, but nonetheless, spring is here. And that's the name of this tune. This is from the Kenton Library. The original version of this was from the Mellophone Band, but Bob Curnow edited it so a normal big band can play it. So this is the Kenton version of Spring Is Here. Seen Anitra?
I did.
Oh, there she is. Our vocalist and sometimes saxophonist, Anitra, to do a couple for you.
Get my tail ready.
I'll just say one thing and then let her introduce it after that. This month, I forget what day, I have it here somewhere, the 100th anniversary of Sarah Vaughan's birth was in March. I don't remember whether it's already happened or whether it's yet to come, but it's in March. And so we're going to do an arrangement that she sang with the Basie Band. And Anitra will tell you all about it.
I have nothing left to share. Caught. Check. Sorry about that, guys. Anybody go to CODA Fest this month? CODA Fest, a couple weeks ago. Thank you. That was such a nice group of musicians that came out and patrons and everything. It was a great celebration of music. But anyway, we did a bunch of these tunes, but some of them not. This one we did not do a couple weeks ago, so hopefully it's nice. Is that how you say your name?
Basie.
Yes, Basie. We love Basie, if you guys can't tell, so I hope you do too. Good.
One, two, three.
when I met him on the corner. He was pouring rain. Yes, I met him on the corner. He was pouring rain. He said, "Come on in here, baby, and tell me what's your name." I said, "Tito's, Tito's is my name."
One more hand for Anitra. And she will be back in the second set for a couple more. I'm gonna talk for a couple of seconds to rest my face before playing this next one. This one is from the Duke Ellington Orchestra. Duke's orchestra was a collection of soloists. It wasn't just four trumpets, it was this guy and this guy and this guy and so forth. And throughout the band, everybody was kind of an individual voice as a soloist, and he wrote parts specifically for them. Not so much second trumpet, but this part's for Cootie. This part, this tune that we're about to play, is a tune that he wrote for his great trombone virtuoso, Lawrence Brown. And I'm going to attempt to not do it too badly. The name of the tune is Blue Cellophane.
Thank you. That was Dr. Don Deal on the trombone. He's gonna conduct, so I'm gonna steal the microphone and talk for a second while he gets up there.
So when I put the set list together, I made sure I got a rest from playing after that. Set. It's about 9 minutes and change, depending on our tempo. And those of you who have been in school bands may be aware the band music is typically graded 1 through 5. 1 is grade school, middle school band. 2 is middle school, easy high school. 3 is the bulk of what high school bands play. 4 and 5 are typically college band material. This is a 6. This is the hardest big band tune I have ever played, and it's not much easier to conduct. It's called The First Circle. It's by Pat Metheny, arranged by Bob Curno. And what makes it so hard is the shifting meters. Most of the piece is in 12/8 plus 10/8. It's a 2-bar pattern that goes 1-2-3, 1-2, 1-2-3, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2, 1-2. Once you get used to that pattern, it kind of flows. But then just when you're used to it, he changes it. And then there's a regular 12-8 bar that's, well, enjoy.
Thank you.
opening set with a transcription of a tune from the classic Machito album, Kenya. This is from, I don't remember exactly what year, late 50s, maybe 58. The name of this tune is Oyeme, and it's from, as I said, the classic Machito album, Kenya. And this was Latin jazz before anybody decided that that's what this genre of music should be called. This is my teacher, Frank Ferriano's arrangement of Clifford Brown's Joy Spring. By the way, last month we celebrated Frank's 98th birthday and he's still with us. Pickups to A, you're right. Let me get the tempo right.
Thank you. Frank Furiano's arrangement of Clifford Brown's Joy Spring, and I think that featured Bruce on trumpet, and Peter on tenor, and Michael on piano. And did I miss anybody? And Anitra's back. By the way, in case you didn't notice, did you notice that she was in the sax section on the previous tune? Well, programming. I gave her a tune to put her alto away before she came back out to sing. And now I'll shut up and let her introduce this tune.
Who likes coffee? I do. Take cream and sugar? Cream and sugar? Any cream and sugars? Black coffee? Anybody?
Yeah.
That's what this song's called. The end. Enjoy. Sorry. I'll work on my intros, guys. Sorry about that.
The Julie London arrangement.
Yeah, what he said.
Thank you.
another Sarah Vaughn tune again. Happy birthday, Sarah! Wherever you are. This is called Just Friends, another bassy tune, so please enjoy. I like it.
Back to the Duke Ellington Library for an alto sax feature. Going to feature Nick, a tune originally recorded on October 22nd, 1971. Johnny Hodges had passed away the year before, so their new lead alto, Harold Giesel Minerva, played this. Giesel, that's a great nickname, Giesel. So the name of this tune is Ad Me. And it's going to feature Nick. Somebody's girlfriend. How many of you remember in the 70s a TV show called The Gong Show.
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember Gene the Dancing Machine?
Of course.
Do you remember the music that he always danced to? It was this tune from the Count Basie band. It wasn't a particularly good recording of it, but this was the tune. So this is the Tommy Newsom arrangement, arranged for the Doc Severinsen Tonight Show band back when Johnny Carson was the host. Composed by Count Basie, arranged by Tommy Newsom, this is Jumpin' at the Woodside. So if you're in a trivia competition and somebody asks, what was Gene the Dancing Machine's theme music, it's Jumpin' at the Woodside.
Thank you.
marching band voice. I have a microphone. Back to the Ellington Library for another tune. And this, I believe, and Bruce will correct me if I say this wrong, I believe this is from the album, His Mother Called Him Bill. And His Mother Called Him Bill. Am I right?
I believe that's correct.
Okay. It's one of the many compositions that Billy Strayhorn wrote for the Duke Ellington Orchestra. Quick backstory. In the 40s, I don't remember what year, Duke needed help because there was such a demand for new music constantly, and even a genius like Duke could only write so much music in a month. So Billy Strayhorn from Pittsburgh auditioned for him and became his alter ego. And Billy wrote some stuff, and Duke wrote some stuff, and sometimes one of them would start the tune, and the other one would write the bridge, the middle section. And when they handed out the music the first time, the band would all try to guess whether Duke wrote that part or whether Billy wrote that part, and usually they couldn't tell. So this is a Billy Strayhorn composition. It's gonna feature Bruce on the trumpet, our Ellington specialist, and the title is Buddha, not Buddha, the, you know, but B-O-O-D-A-H. And I think it's about the articulation. Boo da boo da boo. And I think this probably was originally Clark Terry on this solo. Okay. All right, I'll let Bruce kick it off.
Thank you.
Williams on the trumpet. And let's hear it for the Solid Gold Dancers. Okay, how many of you heard us here 2 weeks ago at CODA Fest? Only a few hands. Good. I can do the same introduction. This next tune was written by Tom Kubas. We have several of his arrangements. He almost always includes a healthy dose of humor in his tunes. If it's not in the music itself, it's in the title. This one, the title kind of tells you everything you need to know about the tune. This is called, as soon as we decide who all the solos are gonna be, this is called Real Loud First Note Blues. Real Loud First Note Blues.
Oh, bass? Yes.
Real Loud First Note Blues. And let me see if I can remember all the soloists. It was Nick on either alto or soprano, I don't remember. And then Alex on trombone. And then Chris on baron. And Michael on piano. And Francis on bass. And Rand on the drums. Back to Basie. This is a Sammy Nestico tune. Sammy's 100th birthday was last month? Yeah, last month. I think he made it to 97 or 98, something like that. He got pretty old, but he's no longer with us, but we celebrated his birthday without him last month, 100. Sammy Nestico, one of the many charts he wrote for the Basie band. And I think without knowing the backstory, I can safely guess that the title refers to a horse, specifically a horse that's not very good at the races. That horse is just a hay burner. That's because Count Basie was a big fan of horse racing. So the title of the tune is Hay Burner. featured Ed Worth on the piccolo and Barry on the trumpet.
Yeah.
Cool. And bits of Michael. Okay, we got one last tune to play. This is it. And this is another one from the great Tonight Show band from the Johnny Carson era. Another Tommy Newsom arrangement. This is a tune from the Ellington Orchestra. One of their better known tunes, one of their many better known tunes. It's a blues in D flat. And it's credited to Duke's son, Mercer Ellington. Legend has it, and this has been presented as fact, that Mercer didn't actually write the tune. One of the sax players in the band wrote it, and Mercer won it from him in a card game. So at any rate, it went down in history. If you look it up anywhere, this tune is officially by Mercer Ellington, Duke's son, who was a trumpet player in the band. This is Things Ain't What They Used To Be. And then hope to see you again next month and every succeeding month. We're the third Thursday of the month. Third Thursday. Okay? And thank you for the loud applause back there.